Fernandes and Loman here tonight in Singapore.
Early opening leg kick coming out of Stephen Loman. He's a power striker. Look how low his stance is, Rich.
Yep, we've talked about this. I don't like the way that Bibby's starting here. I think he needs to come forward more aggressively. He stood back like this against Lineker and ended up getting tagged in the process. So I don't want to see him actually take punches before he decides to put his foot on the gas.
Wild overhand right for Fernandes. Get off balance, and now Loman. Trading kicks to the body. One left from Loman.
Early little engagement right there from Bibiano as he threatened a double leg. And immediately, Stephen Loman dug the underhooks, and then at the exit, was able to throw shots. Bibiano needs to be aggressive. He usually utilizes reach advantage that he's going to have in this one. He needs to put out that jab, start touching him with that right hand, earn some respect from Loman, because Loman is just walking him down.
Bibby's doing a good job of blocking most of the stuff that's coming in, but things are going to eventually sneak through.
But you can also see the way that Loman's kind of following Bibby, right? Bibby is circling to his left, and Loman's kind of just following him rather than coming off the angle.
Loman going up top with that kick and out of the body. This bout judged as a whole, 3 5-minute rounds. Fernandes ranked number 3, Loman number 5.
So he's got Bibby kind of flat on his feet right now, and Bibby needs to be more mobile, whether he decides to come forward or just get out of that range, because Loman's too explosive. His ability to move in on a leg kick like that and then back out before Bibby can actually throw the hook counter.
And you also spoke a little bit earlier about how gun-shy Bibiano might be because of the last result of his fight and getting caught like that. So, and are we seeing that now?
Coming off of a loss like that can be tough on some fighters, you know. And obviously, John Lineker has heavy, heavy hands, you know. And Bibby suffered the
great
takedown from Loman. Not what we expected in the game plan here.
Fernandes back to his feet, but up against the cage, and now Loman looking to take him down again.
Bibiano said that he actually anticipated Loman trying to take him down. It was just too naturally part of his game for him to not be able to do it. So he was expecting to be able to stop some of these takedowns and really force the grappling where he wanted it to be. But that was a nice little entry on that single leg for Stephen Loman early on. Good first 3 minutes for Stephen Loman. I like the outside leg kick. I like how he's setting up that left hand, too. Right? He's touching him with the leg kick. He's scoring points there. But what he's doing is he gets that outside angle so that left hand has more of a center channel to come down the middle.
That's the Bibby I like to see right there. He got really aggressive, ended up landing that overhand right on that exchange there. Not standing flat-footed in front of his opponent like this, but making this a gritty stand-up match and then using that gritty stand-up to actually transition.
Good. Loman going to shake this one off here. Low blow from Bibiano Fernandes here in round number one, past the midpoint. Another leg kick by Bibiano Fernandes. Push kick by Loman.
Bibiano's a veteran. He can eat some of these shots and not take a lot of damage. He's going to be able to figure out a strategy that he's going to be able to implement later on. But these are heavy shots that Loman's firing. Bibiano doesn't want to take too many of them as Bibiano shoots him for a double leg and presses him up against the wall. Nice little redirection right there for Stephen Loman to press him up against the fence.
And Loman looks strong right there on that takedown defense. Just came underneath with those underhooks and just pulled Bibby right up.
Loman looking for the single here. Less than a minute to go in round one. And now Fernandes with his back against the fence.
I know Bibiano spoke about having to fight Kevin Bellion 4 times and prepping for a Team Lakai style and being very familiar with it. But Loman has a completely different style from most of the Team Lakai guys, right? He's got that low center of gravity, one big shot. He utilizes awkward angles with his kicks. It's not really the same Team Lakai style that he's used to fighting.
No, that typical wushu style that you see from those guys, although it's there, don't get me wrong. But the underlying premise of it is changed with the dynamic of that low stance, the low center of gravity, and how he transitions it into his wrestling and his clinch work.
Bibiano dropping down for a single leg. And Loman so far is defending quite well, using like more of an anti-wrestling style to stop some of these takedowns.
Final 10 seconds of round one.
Good first 5 minutes for a sniper.
Loman with a straight left for good measure. Rang number three, Loman number five, and down goes Loman. Bibiano comes storming off of his stool.
Yeah, Bibiano, now he's starting to turn it up as he shoots in there for a single leg. Gets the leg nice and deep. Stephen Loman's trying to defend, push down the head. Good job by Stephen Loman to dig the underhooks and pull Bibby back up to his body lock. And again, looking strong in the redirection and changing the direction and pushing Bibiano up against the wall. I thought Bibiano might have a slight reach advantage, but I do believe they're both 67 inches. So using straight line punches instead of those wide angle punches was great advice by Bibiano's corner to go right down the middle and throw center line channel shots.
Loman peppering the head, now trading right shots to the head. Loman into the double again.
Great takedown. Oh, wow. And just like Bibby always does, man, he's got Loman's back. This is a dangerous place for Loman to be.
Oh, that back take was beautiful. The way that he was able to change and switch around and take the back here, Stephen's going to try to fight the hands and then get his back so that he can spin into the guard. With Bibby only having one hook, it might enable Stephen Loman to start turning. Yep, just like that.
There's the turn for Loman. In the full guard, firing left elbows, and then a couple of rights to the body of Fernandez.
Yeah, this is where Loman really starts to excel when he's in somebody's guard and he's dropping down punches. Bibiano, third degree black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Very good off his back.
The ground and pound effective here from Stephen Loman. Elbows and a couple lefts from Loman. Another elbow to the face of Bibiano Fernandez.
Now, Loman's always effective with his ground and pound, but so far, Bibby's done a pretty decent job of deflecting a lot of what's coming down on him.
Yeah, this is Bibiano's world. This is where he loves. You know, he's got very good defense here. He's keeping his hands up nice and high, but Loman is starting to get through, hitting the ears right there.
Effective with those left elbows. Still 2:50 to go in round two.
Threatening with the triangle, trying to get a hold of the arm. Good job by Loman to defend and then sneak around and take Bibiano's back almost.
Loman sneaks out of there and now he's trying to take the back of the veteran Fernandez.
Wow, Bibiano Fernandez gets his back taken by Stephen Loman, who's going to try to peel off that leg. So Loman's not able to get that second hook in. But good control right now from the sniper.
When was the last time you saw somebody on Bibby's back?
I don't even really see it. Didn't quite see it.
Almost.
But Loman goes in for another takedown.
Another takedown of Bibiano. And another elbow and a hammer fist. Showing everything in his arsenal. In the ground and pound here, Loman inflicting damage on Fernandez.
Yeah, and what this is going to do, it's also going to wear on that gas tank of Bibiano. Right? He's defending a lot. He's taking a lot of shots. I like the body work of Loman. Go to the body, start to drain that gas tank even more.
Yeah, Bibby's not actually doing what he needs to do to break Loman down when Loman's throwing those punches. So if I was him, I'd open this guard up and start moving and getting out of the way, looking to distance myself, maybe actually get back to the feet.
I think he's just trying to slow Loman down. He's trying to tie up the hands. You know, usually you see Bibby with an open guard and he starts attacking more. At least putting the throw on the hips to try to push away. But maybe he's feeling the strength of Loman and he's making kind of a decision that this is a better way to do is just kind of hold him and stop the onslaught so he can regain some energy.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, if this continues for the last 6.5 minutes, Loman's going to win just off of aggression alone because he's on top and doing more work.
Fernandez eating elbows here in the second round, still 70 seconds to go.
Well, he's definitely got a lot in the striking superiority category. Those first 5 minutes, he was able to put a lot of points in the bank by utilizing that left leg and by really just putting in a striking combination. But now we're seeing takedown attempts, grappling, top control. A lot of activity coming from Stephen Loman as Bibiano is trying to lock up an arm.
Loman 40 seconds.
Frantic pace on Bibiano, not giving him a second to breathe.
And we talk about these guys at Team Lakai up in Baguio, man, training in the mountains. Like, they have gas for days.
Triangle. Also, good job by Loman to sneak that arm in there just in time. That's what Bibiano needs to do. He needs to threaten these attacks off his back just so he stops Loman from just unloading on him.
You wonder about the cumulative effect, the damage that Fernandez has taken in this second round.
Well, we're going to see it in about 10 seconds when we have to stand back up and walk to his
right. 5 seconds in round two, a very entertaining second round. Loman back to his feet. No doubt pleased with what
ultra shot.
You got it. Third and final round, 5 minutes to go in this fight.
His corner said, go at him, but here he is, he's standing in front of his opponent again, and it's go time for him now, especially after that second round of spending as much time on bottom as he did.
The bout judged as a whole, so he can turn quickly here.
I like the inside or the outside leg kick that Loman's using. It's often awkward to throw that outside leg kick when you are standing opposite stances, but he's doing a good job of creating the angle and landing and scoring on the left leg of Bibiano.
Loman and Fernandez going toe-to-toe here in the final round. Going in for the takedown, Loman. Bibiano able to escape out of there.
It was a great takedown defense, but keep in mind, Loman has Bibby frozen. He was able to actually take that shot into the way that he was because Bibby's not moving his feet real well.
Big left hand thrown by Loman as Bibiano pushes forward. Definitely that rear leg kick to Bibiano, who looked a little bit labored, didn't quite have the pop that he normally has on it. Like Steve start utilizing that jab. Like his corner said, straight punches for Bibiano. Very important in this round. Final 3 minutes.
Loman using his entire arsenal of kicks. Saw the inside leg kick to the body, then went up top as well here.
I'm watching Loman, and he's just throwing a single strike at a time, whether it be that right hand or that left hand or a kick like that. I'd like to see him put some combinations together. He's moving faster than Bibby right now.
But if it ain't broke, don't fix it. He's doing really well scoring with these shots, and he's kind of got Bibiano frozen and just kind of not really answering back. There's a two-piece. You got to like that.
Well, maybe he heard me. If I was in there, I never wanted anything to go to the judges' scorecard, so I'm always looking at ways to finish.
If you were in there, would you enjoy hearing Rich Franklin here, circle side?
Yeah, I think so.
Giving you advice?
Listen to a bunch of cheat codes. Look at Loman. Nice little entry into the singles. Nice little far leg reap right there with the trip.
Midway through this final round. What entertaining stuff from Fernandez and Loman.
Oh,
Loman the takedown again.
Wow. Next level team Lakai is for show.
Is this officially taking Bibby's back yet or no? There isn't a hook in.
There's no hooks. He doesn't quite have the back. He's kind of just in the top position right here. Has the over-under right now. Press it into him.
I'll just say that if I'm grappling against someone of Bibby's level and I get here, I'm going to consider it a back take. That's just me.
We'll give that to you. Good defense from Bibiano to keep his knee close to his arm so Loman's not able to get that hook in.
Two to go in the fight. Loman has controlled the action throughout.
And going for
Loman again.
Oh, nice battle showcased by a former champ, but second time, he keeps going after it. He's got such a tight grip. He's so strong inside there.
And I'll tell you, this is the gas tank that we talk about with Team Lakai. You pick a guy like Bibby off the ground, and Bibby's able to bounce his way out of that, but he's right back up again.
It was the second attempt to get the adjustment and still get him down like that. Oh, look at Bibiano trying to go for something.
Middle of full guard here, 117 to go.
Nice to roll through. That was nice to get back into full guard though.
Loman mixing shots from both the left and the right, and then that elbow again. Looking to land some stuff to the body and the head. Mixing up nicely with a minute to go in the final round.
Bibby's got to get something busy here because just covering up and blocking his shots isn't going to get done. He has to feel this fight slipping away from him at this point.
We're ground and pound from Loman, 50 seconds to go. Fernandez, in all likelihood, needs a miracle at this point.
Stephen Loman with the ground and pound, just continuously attacking, trying not to take any breaks, not giving Bibiano a moment to regroup, but just continuously putting on the pace and the pressure on the former champ.
Loman said it's his toughest fight yet. I'm going all in. And we have seen that with 20 seconds to go. Loman continuing to fire shots at the face and the body of Bibiano Fernandez. 10 seconds left. Crowd on their feet. What a way to close the show.
And what a great pace to finish out with.
Stephen Loman.